Hi Leo, welcome back to Omkara Tarot. It's Friday, time for another love bite. Leo, let's see what's happening in your love life. What's the message that wants to show through for you today? And please know these are general collective readings, Leo. Will not resonate with all of you out there. Take what works for you, okay? Leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for my Leo gang and send them the messages they need to hear the most about their love life now. Thank you. So Leo, we're going to start with our angel blessing card. Let's see what my angels have in store for you. Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message maybe. My angels, for my lions and lionesses out there, blessing, guidance, advice, or a message. This one. All right, let's put this card here, Leo. And the card I have here for you, Leo, is don't compromise. I don't know what's going on in your love life, Leo, but the angels are requesting you not to compromise. Okay, either, I don't know, let's open the cards and see what that means for you. So welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. Thank you for all the wonderful support that you've been sending, for your lovely comments, your likes, your shares. I'm overwhelmed with your generosity. Thank you so much. Thank you. And of course, Leo, if you're new here, we welcome you too. To join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of our Omkara family. We welcome you in. So Leo, this is just going to be a small little mini love bite. Your longer readings have already been put up. More are coming. And if any of you are looking for a private reading, Leo, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. And bottom of my deck, I have the Tower. My God, what's happening, Leo? Tower moment in your love life? Now, Tower doesn't always have to be a bad thing, you know. Tower basically means a drastic, sudden change to be expected. Okay? So, let's see. Three of Swords in reverse. Okay. Seven of Cups. Six of Pentacles. High Priestess. Ace of Pentacles. Oh, that's nice. Ace of Cups. Five of Cups. Five of Wands and the Sun card. Beautiful. Okay, Leo, from my first look here, somebody wants to heal something that kind of didn't work out. Maybe coming out of a heartbreak, maybe was going through some confusion. But the center of my spread, I do see the Ace of Pentacles, wanting to start again, a stable new beginning, full of love and happiness. Now feeling really bad about whatever, maybe something happened with you guys, right? Which kind of messed up this relationship and created confusion. This had the makings of a very stable relationship, Leo. And maybe now you guys kind of are not really talking to each other. But now somebody does want to start again, stable, a connection full of love. Very apologetic about what happened, about maybe the conflict that was created. And here it is, Leo, your card, the Sun card. We're ending with that. So lots of happiness coming your way, Leo. Let's see. Let's take some dialogue message cards and see what's happening between the two of you. So Leo and the person spirit, if they could say something to each other now. Leo and the person, thank you. Let's take a few more from here. Leo and that person. Leo and that person spirit, thank you. And I'm going to take a couple more from here. Messages from the heart. Okay, thank you. Okay, we're good to go now, Leo. Let's begin your reading. The first card here says, I swear you get more beautiful every day. With age you refine and blossom like fine wine. You're absolutely stunning inside out. That's a sweet message. I didn't run from you. I ran away from myself. It's like deep down, it's all down to my deep fear of rejection and my insecurities. So I think somebody ran even before they got rejected. And now they're feeling, oh my God, what did I do? This had the makings of a beautiful partnership here, and I kind of messed things up here by running because of my own securities, because I thought maybe I'll get rejected here. Okay. Letting you walk away from me is my biggest regret. I should have fought for you and for us. Yes, the blood thickens. It's this ongoing thing, right? They ran away from a connection feeling they'll get rejected. Then their partner had no choice but to move away. And now this person is saying, oh my God, what did I do? I regret now. There's a lot of regret here as to why did I not fight for this connection. It was my own fault, my own insecurity which messed up this connection. I showed you how much I loved you through our kisses. They say if you want to know if somebody loves you, it's in their kiss. Darling, my love for you was in my kiss. I can't ever kiss another like that. The thought of you kissing someone else breaks my heart. I get so fucking jealous knowing that you are in bed with a karmic at night. I feel sick to my stomach at the thought of you making love to someone else. Again, this is insecurity, jealousy, feeling maybe you'll get rejected, maybe the person likes somebody else or is with somebody else, and never really fighting for this connection. I get triggered when I'm angry or have decided to walk away from our connection, and the universe then decides to bombard me with your name, and your higher self stalks me with musical messages from you. So even though this person ran away from the connection, they still haven't forgotten this person, because maybe through music they are reminded of the partner they didn't fight for. I'm healing my heart from past hurt. Yes, this person was already heartbroken when they started this connection. I think they were quite confused as to whether they wanted another partnership or not. I'm healing my heart from past hurt. Give me some time. There is no one in the world as amazing as you. I really need your warmth and affection. Okay. So, yes, the tower moment maybe has already happened, Leo, here, where somebody didn't fight for the connection. What's this Three of Swords spirit for Leo? Three of Swords for Leo. Yeah, somebody wants to get out of this heartbreak. Maybe a potential of a new beginning never really took off, but now they feel, I don't want to be stuck in a place where I'm in a regret. I'm enlightened now that maybe it was my own insecurity or my confusion that I ran from this connection. Seven of Cups. Yes, they didn't believe in love. Maybe they were going through something in their past. Maybe they didn't feel they were good enough to be loved, maybe, or they didn't recognize it as love, maybe. Six of coins. Yes, but I think this connection did make them feel like this can turn out to be a balanced relationship. There was a lot of happiness here. But somebody went silent on this connection with the High Priestess. Yes, somebody tried to pretend they were a player, or they were not consistent, or they never really gave their 100%. They kind of came in and out of the connection, never really giving their all. They didn't put in their effort to make this connection a balanced connection. Maybe they were sitting in their ego and pride, or they were greedy and they said, hey, listen, I've had heartbreak and I don't want to have any serious commitment right now. I'm happy with my nine cups. I'm not interested in anything else. And they try to treat this connection maybe as a very lighthearted or nothing too serious. And the other person, I think, has gone silent on them. But now there is an Ace of Pentacles right in the center. What's that spirit? This is Ace of Pentacles. Ace of Pentacles. Yes, whoever this person was who was running from the connection, I think now is not wanting to be that tough anymore. They are now realizing that, yes, this has the potential for my Four of Wands here, something more stable, something more grounded. And now they don't feel that strong, or I think ever since there's been silence between the two of you, this person has kind of lost their strength. Whatever image they were trying to show, or they were trying to behave like, you know, hey, I'm good, I'm fine, now they don't feel in power anymore, because you can only be in power over somebody who's talking to you, right? So maybe there's silence between the two of you, and this little time of introspection and going within has enlightened this person that I'm doing the wrong thing. I was trying to control something which had the potential of a beautiful new beginning, stability. Not only that, but also love here. Okay? So, Ace of Cups, Spirit. Ace of Cups. Yes, they feel whatever drama they did, or the way they tried to control this connection by pretending to be a player, or pretending to be, hey, I'm okay on my own, or with their ego or pride or whatever. They feel, oh my God, everything backfired on me. This had the potential of something beautiful, and the whole drama that has happened here has backfired. Now, Leo, this could be you feeling that way. This could be your cross watcher who did that to you, right? So you'll know how the story fits. Now, whoever did this camouflage of not wanting this connection is now feeling deep regret. They're feeling, oh my God, I kind of lost something which had the potential of something beautiful, and now they're very conflicted, or maybe they created a conflict. Five of Cups, Spirit. What's this Five of Cups? What's this regret about? Yes, they emotionally tried to hold back on showing how much they cared. They emotionally manipulated their person. They had maybe a little bit of difficulty in telling the person that they were interested. And because it took so long or tried to manipulate the situation, that person walked away. The person has walked away from this because somebody was not showing their true self. Now, whoever was behaving manipulative emotionally is now in deep regret. Oh my God, why didn't I tell them? Because now my person has gone now. Five of Wands. Yes, whoever this feminine was in this equation, I think after this conflict has picked up her sword and saying, hey, I don't deal with people who bring conflict into my life. I think this feminine is genuinely thinking of walking away, I'll be honest. They have a lot of people vying for their attention, I think. Okay? They don't want to be stuck in any kind of connection which is not going to be truthful. They don't compromise. It's like, give me the truth now or I'm out. Okay? Many fish in the sea kind of a thing. This person is very confident of themselves. They are the kind of person who can walk into a room and many people want their attention. Okay, this person wants a connection which will have an easy flow. Like things should move smoothly. If you're going to play any kind of games with me, I'm out. So, what's the Sun card then, Spirit? What's the Sun card? Sun card. At the moment, Leo, there's a lot of healing that still needs to happen in this connection. Somebody has realized what they've done. It's been a tower moment in their life, because somebody was sitting in their ego and pride and not giving attention to this connection. Now this person is in hermit mode. Why? Because their partner has kind of stopped moving towards this connection, because they were never shown the attention. This person is moving towards their own happiness. They're looking at other options now. Something that can be honest, open, happy and joyful. They want something which is going to make them happy. They are, I think, putting an end to this connection, as it seems now. They're not compromising on anyone who's going to... So, anything else, Spirit, for Leo? Is it over or... No, somebody may just come back. Somebody may just come back because to make the things right and heal this connection. This is a very strong soulmate connection, Leo. There was a good friendship maybe at one time, but somebody didn't want to take it to the next level. They were playing mind games and their partner kind of didn't compromise and is now checking out their new options only because they want to be happy. They don't want any drama in their life. But I do feel that somebody is going to try and heal this broken hearts and return. This is a card of somebody coming back from your past. So, yes, maybe this time round, you've both learnt your lesson after this tower moment, Leo, and things can go beautifully between the two of you. There's a lot of thinking that has gone, a lot of back and forth as to why I did what I did and feeling left out and abandoned, but really, really now wanting a reunion now and actually wanting to invest in this connection, maybe wanting a commitment as well for, something which will be more long-term. Instead of just an in and out energy. Okay, so yes, whoever didn't compromise in the situation, I think did the right thing. And the one who was playing mind games have had their wake up call and things can turn around. There can be a big transformation which is going to make you guys really, really happy if played right now. Okay, that's all I have. Thank you, Leo, for being here. Love and light. See you on Monday now for your in-depth reading. Namaste.